well within the pharma space, but yes, it would definitely be in the top three.
Dilip, hi, good afternoon. Yesterday, one guest made a point that in last 2 months, it's added one Glenmark in its market cap. We have Glenmark's market cap of
well
20,000 crores.
Yeah.
And its Sun's market cap is now approaching 1.9 lakh crores. So, and everything is good at a price. So, would you have courage to buy Sun Pharma at, say, 28, 29 times next year forward earnings?
Well, I think the fundamentals have been very well brought out by my friend out over here. I think I just need to add a couple of things out over here before I really come to the final pointed answer. I think the company is sitting on a $2 billion of cash, and every year they're adding almost about $350 to $400 million of cash. And now if you were to add Rann Bakshi after the merger to this, I think there is still a tremendous scope for even Rann Bakshi to really improve its margins, almost doubling the margins, even if they have to really bring it to the industry standard after the merger. But I think Sun Pharma needs to be looked at from a slightly different perspective. It is in the same league as that of, say, HDFC, HDFC Bank, ITC, Levers. So if you're building your core portfolio, it is very difficult to imagine a core portfolio without Sun Pharma. So then the question comes is whether in the short term, is it expensive? Maybe. But does it matter so much? I don't think so. I think this is a stock which you will always think of acquiring. Even if there is a correction or even if there is a rise, we'll keep on buying this particular stock.
Okay.
So I think...
So let me just ask you this way, the same question I asked Nipun, but if you were to buy today to fill in your pharmaceutical portfolio, would you buy it?
Without any doubt, and I would go one step ahead and say, if you were to build your top 10 or 12 stocks across all the sectors, Sun Pharma would also deserve a place in that. So I think it has to be seen from that, because this is a company which is generating a good amount of free cash. And you know, the way they are distributing the dividends, the ROEs, the way it is at 25-26%, and the way the scope is further, it may appear expensive, but it is a must in your portfolio.
It is a must in your portfolio, but if you were to pick three stocks to buy today, pharma stock, would you figure in that?
Very much. I think this would be one of the, this would be the top stock. Maybe Lupin would be the another stock that I would have in my portfolio.
Nipun, what about you? What would be your pecking order for pharma stocks?
Well, it would be Sun Pharma, Lupin, and then Aurobindo Pharma.
In terms of any kind of delay in Rann Bakshi's merger, do you expect any kind of negative reaction on the stock, or would that not be a point of worry?
Well, I think the market has factored in a particular kind of time frame that is there. So even if there is a delay, we don't believe that could be a serious concern, unless it get delays like beyond a year or two, which is probably unforeseen circumstances. But I think, like Dilip was mentioning, very clearly with the kind of cash on hand that is there, inorganic growth will continue to be a serious part of Sun Pharma's business, and that's something that will keep triggering that higher growth that one foresees over the next several years. So for sure, I think Sun Pharma would deserve a place in the portfolio.
All right, that's a word of confidence for Sun Pharma, even at these prices. Nipun, Dilip, stay with us. We'll come back to you with more market questions. Right now, let's take stock of the fact that we've added on to our meager gains in late afternoon trade. Some stocks that have continued to do well, helping the Nifty recover, are banking stocks. So you'll see that reflect in the Bank Nifty. You'll see that play out on Bank of Baroda, PNB, SBI seems to have cut some of its losses, HDFC. These are some of the stocks that have helped the markets recover in late afternoon trade. Another stock you want to keep your eye on is Jindal Steel and Power. So take a look at that intraday chart, because we've seen a big spike up in JSPL and similarly in DLF as well. Now, all right, let's now get to Pritesh Mehta. He's standing by to tell you what to buy or sell today for a reverse trade tomorrow. Pritesh, good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Before I talk about my recommendations, let me just put in a word regarding Nifty. The index is going through a phase of painful consolidation between 8300 and 8400. In fact, in last couple of days on multiple occasions, it came close of bridging the support on downside, but we bounced back. During such phase of confusion, it is best advised to stick with a larger trend, which continues to remain on the upside. So yes, as long as Bank Nifty continues to be in a range-bound trade, this is going to be a stock-specific market. And moving on, talking about stocks, our first recommendation is buy on Crompton Greaves. Now, this stock is in a strong uptrend since Jan 2014. In fact, it's gone through a bit of correction in September and October, but it is now showing its true potential. The selling pressure is exhausted, and I believe the stock has given a breakout from a downward sloping trend line. So yes, buy for a target of 206. A second recommendation is buy on Bank of India. Now see, I believe that most of the banking stocks, especially PSU banks, are showing signs of, you know, building a strong base, and they are getting ready for a big up move. So from the basket of PSU banks, Bank of India looks the best bet. In fact, if you look at the chart, it has given a strong rally from the levels of 224 to 290. And thereafter, it went through a period of consolidation. This consolidation eventually took shape of a flag pattern. In today's trade, it is breaking off in the same pattern. So buy for a target of 310.
All right, Pritesh, thanks for that. Let's head out to Varinder Bansal. He's got a list of stocks buzzing in late afternoon trading. Varinder?
Well, clearly in the last half an hour, we just see some of these stocks like Shriram EPC, which has moved up 8%. C8 has actually come out of nowhere. You just see the last half an hour chart, again the stock has spiked up nearly 6%. While you were talking about Sun Pharma, but Cadila and Ipca Labs, they saw some buying happening in the last half an hour. And in small caps, it's Meghmani Organics, again the stock was up nearly 10-12%. AGC Networks, which is SR Group company, was up 20%. TCA Finance up 10%. Tata Metalics, very good set of numbers, the stock moving up 10%. ADF Foods up by nearly 6-7%. Jindal Saw, keep an eye on this stock because those large deals which happened on exchanges today, the stock is up by nearly 6-7%. We'll wait and see who was a buyer, who were the buyers in the evening today. And Singer India, the stock has been moving very steadily, up 8% today, was up 5% yesterday. This stock is on many HNI's radar, so watch out for this stock in the coming few days. All the medical equipment companies, after DIPP proposed 100% FDI in medical equipment, Opto Circuits up 20%, Polymedicure up nearly 4-5%, BPL, again one of the division is in medical devices, up by nearly 6-7%. Polaris is seeing some buying today, up nearly 7.5%. Well, it's single day today and there's a lot of shopping which is going online around the world. So all the logistic companies are buzzing today, whether it's Gati, which is up 6%, Patel Integrated Logistics up 11%, TCA up 4%, Butart up by nearly 5-6%. And some of the results, you know, huge expectations but not delivered, all of them getting punished. You know, TV Today down 15%, Lord Electric down nearly 14%, Jyoti Structures down 12%, Omex, Penar Industries, JB Chemicals, all down nearly 5%. Other stocks, you know, On Mobile has been just steadily moving, but today some profit booking seen on that stock. Colte Patil, Netco Tiles, 8K Miles, again profit booking seen in all the stocks. Watch out for Tata Steel, BPCL, Adani Enterprise, Eicher Motors, Nalco, JP Associates. All these will be reporting numbers tomorrow, so important to watch out for them.
Hey, Varinder, Gati delivers in China or what?
No, but there's Snapdeal, Amazon, all of them.
Sentiment drop-off. Sentiment drop-off.
Your front page ads today.
Huge sale which is going on. Most of our colleagues are there on the Snapdeal and Amazon since morning.
Anuj was on Snapdeal at 7 a.m. today. I know, I was shocked.
There's nothing on that.
By the way, Anuj, you will be delighted since you're a Xiaomi owner that Xiaomi sold apparently 720,000 Mi phones. That's ridiculous in one day. Yeah. 720,000 phones in one day.
They're already the world's third largest mobile player now without even leaving Asia. This is just Asia sales.
This is just Asia.
Just Asia sales.
And mostly China.
Mostly China.
Mostly, because in India, they've been selling like a few thousand every now and
indeed.
Then. Right?
They can tease you with those
phones. And next month, they're going. I think they're going to raise funds, which is going to make them the largest listed mobile company. It's possible that may happen. By the way, since you spoke about Mi, I managed to add Mi 4 on the Chinese website, AliExpress.com. It's the other thing that I didn't go through with the order, but didn't want to deal with in foreign exchange, so that's why.
Okay, all right. Anuj is our resident. How to get the best deal on an online sale expert, so to speak. We'll get back to markets?
Yeah, let's get back to markets. We've got Dilip Bhatt and Nipun still with us. Dilip, seeing strength in banks today, as Menaka pointed out earlier, PNB up quite nicely, Bank of Baroda up quite nicely. We had a pretty good set of numbers come in from Punjab and Sindh Bank. How would you play them now? And do you think the running quarter, for the quarter that we are in currently, will show a distinct uptick in most banking results?
Well, I think the distinction between the private and the PSU still remains, mm-hmm. particularly in terms of the asset quality. While the markets have really run ahead, I think the ground level reality still is that the NPAs still are haunting everybody, and I think the asset qualities are yet to improve. Okay. So I think perhaps one more quarter we may still see the overhang of the asset quality on the PSU banks and not so much on the private sector banks. So if you were to take a slightly longer term view, I think within the banking space, PSU banks should be acquired around these levels. Maybe the time frame will be much longer. But I think two, three factors. One is there could be a change of the way the top management is appointed, and that itself may involve some kind of re-rating. And if there is some uptick and some further momentum given by way of economic push, I think the PSU banks will also benefit. So I think considering the fact that overall PSU banks are still very muted as compared to the private sector banks, PSU still looks pretty good, slightly from a longer term perspective. But in the near term, for next 3 to 5 months, I think it is still on a momentum basis, the private sector banks, particularly HDFC, IndusInd Bank, I think, and Yes Bank particularly looks pretty good in the short run.
Dilip, what's the call on M-Tech Auto? That's one stock which has again gained some 16-17% today, is up 150% year to date.
Well, I think as far as that company is concerned, if this deal which has been announced in the paper, if that is correct, I think they are substituting a big amount of costly debt with a cheap debt. And not to forget that their major earnings are in foreign currency. So in that sense, they have a very good natural hedge. And not to forget also that this company is also almost about, has got a turnover of 16 to 17,000 crore. That's quite a bit. And they're also in the process of trying to raise some money on the QIP front. So all said and done, I think from the current levels, with this kind of matrix, which is now getting in place, I think this stock can really get further re-rating. And I think it will invite some more attention from the investors.
Nipun, what's your call on this one? Easily one of the stocks of the day today.
Sure, we don't track it closely, but I think the auto space run-up has been significant, at least the auto ancillary space, there's been a significant run-up. And if there are maybe one or two quarters of muted numbers as far as the auto space is concerned, and which we probably saw to some extent as far as the festive season was concerned, if that does happen for a couple of more months, you could just see some amount of sort of selling off that might happen as far as the auto ancillary space is concerned. So yes, I think the overall space does look good individually, company wise wherever we've seen excellent results for the September quarter or even for the June quarter, there's been a significant run up that has been seen, complete re-rating that has happened as far as the auto ancillary space is concerned. But one needs to be cautious and one needs to be very selective about which companies in the autos and the auto space one is looking at.
Rahul, interestingly, when we asked you for your picks earlier on the show, you went with large caps. So is that indication of your belief in where the Nifty is going to go? Because till yesterday, we had people preferring to play short-term calls in the mid-cap if they were going long.
I think there are two factors that go into my thinking. One is, of course, that yes, you've seen a major market run-up and you know it's time to probably be a little cautious, get a little conservative. On the Nifty, secondly, my view is we are going to see big bouts of resistance as we approach that 8500 level. Now, in a percentage basis, we're not very far away from that, and which is why I tend to get very selective. And just to give you a bit of a better understanding.
But you picked Reliance and HDFC, both really of whom have a pretty heavy weightage in the Nifty. So if they are to go up, you're going to see the Nifty go up as well.
Absolutely. I think the next 4 or 5% on the index or these stocks, and I'm really talking very short term, is positive. So, you know, from a trading perspective, I think these stocks are looking very good. But would I buy them for the next 15 to 20% right away? I don't think so.
Okay. So, Rahul, in terms of mid-caps, what do you think is going to give better returns from here on? Would it be high beta names like GMR, Suzlon, GVK? Or would it be relatively safer bets like Arvind, Apollo Tyres, which have done well all through this year?
No, I think out of the stocks that you named, Arvind, Apollo Tyres, two which have really done well, and I think they still have more momentum to go. Again, I wouldn't say that there's a huge bout that I'm expecting here, but I think these would be the safer ones to be with. I still feel that when you look at some of the mid-cap banking names, you could have good short-term momentum. And when you look at some of the selective mid-cap pharma names as well, there too I would be interested. I would tend to stay away from, you know, technology stocks, the oil and gas space. So, you know, it's got to be very, very sector-specific as well at this point in time.
Okay, by the way, some news from Mahindra and Mahindra. They have raised prices of both passenger vehicles and commercial vehicles by 1 to 2%. I think I just saw that. Yeah. The stock up about 2.5% at this point in time. Dilip, your call on M&M?
Well, I think for the second consecutive quarter, the numbers were a lot more muted and a little disappointing. But by and large, I think this stock also remains very much as a top pick. I think in spite of the fact that the volume numbers also have not done anything great, I think if you're having a slightly longer term time frame, this stock certainly qualifies as one of the top picks in your portfolio.
Okay. Also, Nippon, a word on railway stocks, which got excited because of the new minister and which market believes is going to do maybe wonders to the ministry. Your call on some of these names?
Well, at least on an expectation basis, on an optimism basis, they look positive. I think based purely on expectations that there will be significant changes that could happen, improvements that could happen. Yes, a lot of these stocks have run up. For sure, I think given the kind of sentiment that had been expressed by the Prime Minister earlier, there would be significant changes that could be expected as far as performance of the railways is concerned, and clearly some of these stocks would benefit out of that. Maybe Texrail or Titagarh probably comes to mind in terms of how they could really benefit out of a lot of these changes that could come about. Our sense is there has been a significant run-up. Markets would probably still want to wait for some of that to start showing up in terms of results over the next couple of quarters before there is a significant move upwards that could happen on some of these stocks.
All right, that's the market bell going off. We're at the end of trade. Let's take stock of where we finally closed the day. 21 points in the green on the Nifty. That's a quarter of 1% at 83.65. That's above that 83.50 level. The Sensex up about 60 points. That's also about a fifth of 1% at 27,934. So that's just about 70 points away from 28,000. Now, on the gaining front, you had some strength come back to financials, as we've been talking about in the last couple of hours. So the top gainers on the Nifty were PNB, Bank of Baroda, IDFC. These are stocks that ended with about 2 to 4% in terms of gains. Then you had M&M that did well today, up 2.6%. Ultratech Cement was up about 2.4%. Ambuja was up almost 2%. Tata Steel had a good day today, gaining more than 2%, as did DLF, which was up over 1%. A bunch of other private sector banks, such as Axis Bank, ICICI Bank, the other big financial player, HDFC, they all went home with gains. We had some support come in from heavyweights, such as Reliance, that was up almost 1%. And Pharma didn't do so badly in trade today. On the losing side, you had FMCG, so ITC, HUL, Asian Paints. These are all stocks that ended with losses. ITC faring the worst, down about 2%. You had IT stocks that didn't do very well today, led by Infosys, which was down about 1%. HCL Tech was also weaker. So was Wipro. I think TCS did manage to end in the gains though. And two-wheeler stocks, both Bajaj and Hero, had a rough day today, so they were both down in the red. Besides that, BHEL was the top loser on the Nifty. That was down over 2%. Midcap, guys?
Yeah, quite a bit of outperformance, Menaka. The index was up about 0.7%, so the index itself was up, but big gains in individual stocks. Amtech Auto really would go down as one of the stocks of the day, up 17%. Opto Circuits was up 16%. Jindal saw up 8%. Then you had HCC, Hindustan Construction, reacting to that Lavasa IPO issue. That stock was up 8%. Gen Irrigations up 8%. Midcap banks did quite well, both PSU and private banks. So Karnataka was up 6%. Allahabad up 5%. Andhra up about 4%. And Union Bank was up about 3%. And on the losing side, a couple of names. Pennar Industries was down about 6%. And Suzlon Energy was down about 4%. Overall market volumes quite okay, actually. Cash market volumes of 17,000.
Right, about though.
Yeah, but cash market quite okay, 17,000.
And almost a mirror of yesterday's trade.
Almost a mirror of yesterday's trade.
Open high. I mean, range bound, but open high.
Range bound.
Went down and came back.
It's just that mid caps outperformed a bit more in today's trade than they did in yesterday's trade. So that stood out in today's trade. Okay, let's get back to our guest then, Dilip. ITC, yesterday, of course, the stock was up 3.5%, and it looked like there was a bit of an overreaction to Harshvardhan being moved out of health ministry. Today, it's retraced half of those gains, down about 2%. It's been a big underperformer all through this year. What's the call on this one now?
I think this is just going to be a very steady story as far as ITC is concerned. Unlike the rest of the market, which really went like a rocket, I think ITC has been a very steady performer in the last 5 years too. And I think with a 17 to 18% bottom line growth CAGR expected for next about 3 to 4 years, and maybe about 30% ROE, I think this stock will continue to give about 10 to 15% return on a longer term basis. I think that is what probably will happen as far as ITC is concerned. Maybe the budget news may temporarily either derail or may give some push. But on a longer term basis, it will still be a gradual movement.
Was it the moving out of the change of guard at the health ministry, or just the news finally coming in on that SUTI ETF? Because, right, that makes it very clear now that the government does not intend to directly sell those stakes, and that it intends to create a tracker stock of sorts, which means that those who were probably worried, saying, look, you know, given the tax shortfall we're seeing this fiscal, are we going to see the government come out and sell Axis Bank, sell ITC? That overhang has gone away. Maybe it's that more than
anything
else.
Maybe the combination
else.
Both. And
because
maybe,
neither the outgoing health minister nor the incoming health minister at a variety of levels are incredibly confidence-inspiring in any fashion, right?
No, this was about the outgoing health minister being seen as too strict on tobacco products and tobacco companies. So there's just a bit of relief. I think the first half rally quite clearly yesterday was, I think, on account of that.
I
think there was a simplistic view that said that it was the health ministry view, and then there was the more sophisticated view that was the SUTI view playing out.
I'm guessing that's probably that one sort of sword hanging over the stock that's taken away in some sense. Though how that ETF will do in itself is a big question mark.
Indeed.
Right?
Rahul, a word on cement stocks. They did quite well today. Ambuja Cement in particular, up about 2%. Again, being an underperformer compared to its peers. But how would you trade it?
I don't see a major breakout on the stock, but I have to admit that maybe we're heading to about 240 in terms of a price target. So even from here, there is headroom, keeping a stop loss at 218, which I see as medium term support levels, one could be trading into 240. I mean, for that matter, even ACC, as I said, it all looks like the next 5 to 8% looks fairly clear on some of these heavyweights, including cement. So should be good going for the next couple of days.
Okay. Rahul, in terms of these mid-cap PSU banks charts, which one looks good to you? Because there are a variety of stocks over there.
Well, amongst the banking names, if you didn't force me necessarily into true mid and small, I think Bank of Baroda is a stock I like, despite having run up quite a bit. I'm positive on the short term, and I like to look at this as as an opportunity where you would really get into the momentum, get the next 5 to 10%. So Bank of Baroda would selectively be one stock. IDFC would be a second, which I like amongst the financials. If I had to go down the list, maybe Karnataka Bank, another stock which I think can suddenly start performing. So these would be the three stocks I'd look at within the sector.
Dilip, we spoke about some other auto ancillary company, but Motherson Sumi came out, didn't quite meet the street expectations on numbers yesterday, so it got knocked a bit. Today it's come back just a little. How is that looking for you? Is it expensive at these prices?
Well, our analysis shows that maybe if you were to take off the one-off which has really impacted the overall margins, I think the margins are very close to what we were expecting. So I think overall the results may not have really exceeded, but it still looks pretty good. I think we are still in for a 27 to 30% growth in the bottom line, a steady 20-22% top line growth, and an ROE in excess of 30%. And it also shows that the management is very nicely managing all the acquisitions, and they are showing it in terms of the results with all the parameters being intact. So I think Motherson Sumi still looks pretty good. Even if it has corrected, it still merits a look. One should acquire even from those levels. I think slightly on a longer term basis, it can easily give 25-30% annual appreciation.
Rahul, what are your thoughts on a couple of these large cap names? One is Bharti Airtel, which has again gone into no man's land, and the other is Coal India, almost going through the same process.
No, I'm a little worried with Bharti Airtel, particularly the stock's not been able to stay above 395, which was a key level. So even today, closer to 390, 395, we saw that pressure come in. Somewhere, I think 360 is where the stock is heading to. So in the near term, I would be negative on Bharti Airtel. So that would be a sell call. At this point in time, as I said, there are some stocks which do look negative even within that frontline set, and that would really move towards technology, telecom. These are the kind of sectors which I would be a bit worried about.
Okay, Dilip, technology, how would you trade that? You had serious bit of correction post the TCS and HCL Tech numbers, but there's been quite a bit of recovery since then. TCS in particular, how would you trade that?
I think after the results, TCS particularly has taken it on the chin, and it has remained at those levels. It did attempt some kind of recovery, but I think that has really been very weak. But overall, I think TCS still continues to show a good, at least 5 to 5.5% quarter on quarter growth. And I think even the bottom line growth will continue to be pretty strong in that sense, assuming that 5% quarter on quarter growth will continue, which is what our broader expectation is. TCS is not cheap, but still, I think, considering the fact that it has still got a good traction, good visibility, I would still play for this stock for next 3 to 6 months very easily. I think it can easily give another 10 to 15% return from the current levels over next 3 to 6 months.
Well, thanks, Dilip, for joining us. Rahul, thanks, Nipun, thank you for joining us. Time to slip in a short break. Tata Steel and Eicher Motors are two of the many companies that will come out in numbers tomorrow. And we'll get you the expectations on these two after a very, very short break. Stay right there.
When you talk of profitability, actually, again, one of the major milestones in the last few years has been the fact that our return on assets and return on equity has actually doubled in the last 4 to 4.5 years. About 4.5 years ago, 5 years ago, our return on assets was less than 1, which is now 1.8.